I think I've played one game since going overseas in March, so definitely keen for a few more games. Yeah, you know, it is what it is, and you know, I've had some good times around, you know, different coaches at IPL and working on a few things, but I guess it is game time that, you know, that really, really gets you ready. You know, if you're not getting games, you're obviously in the nets, you're working on things. And I guess being in the UAE leading into the World Cup is obviously a good thing. You know, familiarise yourself with the conditions, and no doubt spin's probably going to be a big factor of the World Cup, which is nice. Trying to get around some of the local Indian guys, you know, get around like MS Dhoni, Rayner, their kind of knowledge about, I guess, playing spin in slower conditions because they grow up playing, and then, you know, you've got like Mike Hussey's the batting coach, and you've got Stephen Fleming as well, which is nice to obviously, you know, like pick their brain and stuff. In the UAE, it could be similar to that 2016 World Cup where it was quite slow.
This is the first match in the Super 10 in the ICC World T20 2016. India, the host, taking on New Zealand.
Yeah, it's a pretty good day.
Oh, the stamping, Chante takes it. He had to juggle it, did Ronki, but eventually he got it to the stumps. Roy Sharma was in far enough down the pitch. Back down edge, another wicket. The third one down, Rayner's second delivery. He just chips it to short the wicket, closes the face of the bat.
It was one of those ones where we rocked up and it was looked like it was going to favour spin, and but you obviously don't know how much. And I think I remember the first ball Guppy hit one for six. I was like, shh, we're on here. But yeah, it's one of those things where everyone was a bit excited, you know, first game, playing the hosts. And then, you know, I think as a unit, we bowled extremely well. And even to get to 120 odd with the bat was, you know, it was going to be a defendable score on there. But yeah, I guess that kind of got the ball rolling, and then we went on and won a few more games, which was nice.
There he goes for the biggie. Oh, what a catch. Nathan McCullum pulls off a scorching catch. It's a fourth wicket for Mitch Santner. It's 79 for 9.
I guess I've been around the team for a while now. Played, I guess, over 50 odd matches. So yeah, it's you know, it's something I feel, you know, reasonably comfortable in a T20. We've got a good squad, and you know, we cover all aspects, whether it's, you know, the spinners, we've got a few young batters, we've got some experience as well. So I think in the kind of T20 format, if you get on a bit of a roll and kind of use that momentum to keep going, you can go pretty far.